So today in this video, I want to talk about the recent years, of course, about the popular trend of Disney doing with their amazing live action movies of original animated films. Now, personally, the reason why I want to make this video is very clearly because they are really pushing too hard with the live action movies. Because, this makes me like from the, by the title I'm saying that Disney is losing their creativity. Like, if you remake old movies that were animated into live action, that's oh yes, that's two things: very cheaply, and that's basically have doing playing it safe because you can. You can add something or remove it, remove something from what was in the animated movie. And we have a very big, good example for it, for the movies. Like, for example, good examples is like, if you look how sometimes different the live action movies from the animated movie. Like the characters, who how they move, how they react. Overact away. It's really can say a lot. Like the Beast, the Beauty and the Beast is a good example of how you're not doing a live action movie. How CGI can really ruin a movie, and does not make it really to a movie, but lose the touch with it. I like you. I see that you see some clips from like trailers in the background from those movies. I'm like. Dude, we're going to now look at the list of all the animated movies and live action movies that are coming next. And it's really shocking that Disney does not really want to invest animated movies that much. Most of the time it's Pixar and not really the other studios. What is pretty stupid, man. And we need more creativity. We need more awesome talent to Disney because, dude, yeah, you have Disney has a lot of stuff. They have Marvel, they have Star Wars, they have lots of different stuff. But they always try to milk and milk this type of stuff too much. Like Star Wars is now really milked to death in those movies. Like seriously, cannot end it. Cannot make a last like a final movie to finally close the story whatsoever. Cannot do that. As well as like Marvel, you have make great so awesome movies about, but you can also stop with that, those movies because you can tell a story of a specific character like too much. But like Spider-Man, how many movies do Spider-Man has? Another. Iconic characters series. So now we're going to take a look at the list of movies. So now we're going to the future releases. Amazing. So the first time we have Dumbo, what is like you see in the background of like the original movie from 1941. So, like, time of the Second World War. Awesome. Then we have other things like Alden, also a classic movie. Apparently, Will Smith is going to play the main Will Smith.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just want to roll that part from the YouTube rewind. Because really, Will Smith as Aladdin can make him as funnier than that. Then we have Toy Story 4. Great man, we're going to have another sequel of a movie. This last one is 2010. Great. For some reason, because it is popular, you're going to make another one. And this is not really this really adds to the storyline, or is this so to cashing in. singer. And like we have The Lion King. Was like again like one see you in those clips I can see a beckons when just talking. And it's like it looks good, you can see that. I see it's not in a live action movie because there's no human people in that. But I have some stories that they are going to remove the scene on the end of the movie, the original Emmett movie, about the whole fight scene between those two lions. It's rumors, eh? But seriously, wait a minute. Yeah, okay. What I've seen, it looks beautiful, but does not feel like the original movie. It's not animated CGI. I don't see that it's going to be less of work. It's going to be not going to be a fucking bad whatsoever. But I'm going to say it. It's going to be touched for the original people who really enjoy The Lion King. And there was also with amazing sequels, like, seriously. They also have a spin-off, like, whatever. It was like Timon and Pumbaa, the series. You have also have The Lion Guard, whatever, on Disney Junior, whatever. Doesn't really seem like a junior cartoon, to be honest. And because it's a 20-year anniversary... Wait, where is it? Right here. 25th anniversary of the original movie, we're going to have a live action one. I'm a bit thirsty. And, you know, there's one thing to do that we cannot like say, hey, we're going to go to the theaters, going to rerun that movie, the original one. So, whatever. It's on July 19. Basically, like, 13 days after my birthday. Like, I'm going to be honest, even though I personally don't like live action movies, I'm probably going to see it, even though, like, I'm not really going to feel that often anymore. Like, the last time was like the Mission Impossible, the recent movie of that. Whatever. Then we're going to have Frozen 2, again, a sequel, the original one. From 2013, wow, it's time ago. Onwards, new movie that we don't know about. Fantasy. But who knows, human characters or whatever, elves, trolls, unicorns. We'll see what that's going to be. We're going to be on and on. Lady and the Trump is also... Oh, just see what's... Wait a minute, guys. There's a new release. I have no idea what supposed means. Going to be remaking it as well. Sorry. We're going to have two anime movies, and you have Captain Nemo. I thought it was something from Nemo, that movie. Disenchantment. What the hell? Are they going to make that again, a movie about that? Seriously. That was like a very horrible movie. I remember that I have to watch it with school, with lower school, whatever. That was a terrible movie. At least what I think. It was too much singing, in my opinion. Then we have that, Dragon Empire. Expected Gadget. Cool, again, wow. A movie that we not necessarily need. Lilo and Stitch, no, that animated movie, and the series going to do that as well as a goddamn live action movie. Going to be that Stitch, it's going to be a very, not really good looking CGI character. Peter Pan again. Second Jungle Book, seriously not a sequel. Go to the desert as well. Because it makes too much money. Go to make another one. Like, seriously, guys, I know that in the personal climate of this, that Disney is not really going to be creative for a long time. I know there's going to be different types of animated movies and other types of stuff as well that Disney is going to make. But, like, how they lost the touch is so very bad. Like, now, again, they also have, like, what is it, on the Disney Channel. They're going to have an amazing, awesome, live-action movie of Kim Possible. Like, seriously,
so a few years ago, Kim Possible ended in 2007.
And it's going to release this year, 2019, homework, so as a live-action movie.
I answered it.
And I'm like,
now, well,
why the hell is your target demographic?
Who am I?
Disney Channel.
I'm Kim Possible.
Or Disney, whatever. Because most of the people are like my age, older, just a bit younger than me. And like, seriously. Well, from what I saw, it looks very cheap. Because it's a typical live action movie of Disney. That they are cheap on the Disney Channel. There were some okay movies, I guess, not really that bad. Like, they have to have the old low budget on their movie. And as well, and it will make people worse because
fucking yes, the Disney Channel original movie coming to
like,
Disney Channel
does not resemble the characters. Like, for example, Kim Possible herself is basically how she looks. It's like she looks like a fucking like 16 years. She was originally was. I'm happy that like seriously, you know the Final Palace movies. Those movies, you have Drake Bell and Deanna Bonet or whatever. Those guys, those people are like 18 years old, while Timmy and Tutti, whatever, those guys were 10 years old. And you also have like, who was like AJ and AJ and Chester, whatever. Those guys from that live action movies. It was like in their 30s or in their 40s. While all those characters, most of the characters, are fucking children. Does not make any sense for the storyline whatsoever. They have Timmy supposed to have already lost their very old parents a long time ago. And same with Kim Possible movies. If you look how she dressed up, it's like a PG family friendly version of Kim Possible because they don't want to not see their actual body. Because you know, you can't have kid young boys have their penises larger. So you see. And then you also have like the also unstoppable that is not also not really pretty much they does not really look like a original one. As well as Rufus. It's not going to probably not in the movie or not very much because they are not going to spend the time on CGI and recreating Rufus the animal itself because they won't want to spend money on it. They also have other characters like the one character that also is going to brief in Kim Possible at the missions is. A younger version is she. He looks younger than in the animated series, like that character apparently from Death's Home or whatever. Really makes me sad. See, and also, but villains look cheap. The mission looks cheap. Even trying to have action scenes or super stuff like I see this saw the sneak peek of it. Well. Kim Possible was running to the high school bus. I was like, cool. It was want to make from a typical daily thing routine to an awesome action sequence. Like, oh my god! You see, a mom with a car of a baby. She loses grip, loses control, and like Kim goes to that car, saves the day. With a grappling hook, I was like, awesome, you also always have a grappling hook. went with you, and like, seriously, and like, oh yeah, she's running to the bus, and it's like, oh my god, she's not going to make it, but will she make it? Yeah, because everybody knows, yeah, that buses have always have a time of going away. Like, this does not make any sense whatsoever. But if you see, oh yeah, Kim is coming, oh, we're going to have the door a bit open. No, we're going to have a timer, going to say, oh yeah, that amount of time, you need to go in the bus. Like, this is also a bit stupid. Let's really see how very young Disney wants to have their atomic demographic with this this movie, because kids like that. I don't know, but you have to say with Disney and their admin and the original movies, they always have something with high schools and with musicals. That's a problem that I have. Always every single movie, except of like a few, whatever it was, like a Wizards of Waverly Place movie. There was like two movies, and then second Cody Studio, what did you have in that movie, whatever. But most of the movies are musicals. Always high school teams. And it's like, oh yeah, we have a zombie movie. And Tom was like, oh my god, zombies. And I saw like a sneak peek of it, like a teaser. I was like, this is saying zombies is a positive way. I'm like, I thought there's going to be a zombie apocalypse. And it was like about a boy who was half zombie, half human or whatever. And he's going to high school. And it would be one of the cool kids, whatever. And he's going to dance. All the stupid stuff, it was like, does not make any sense whatsoever. I never not really saw the original movie itself, but personally, from what I see, it's pretty stupid. Sorry. Like, seriously, this is the type of stuff that really frustrates me a lot about Disney. So incompetent about how such Disney Channel wants to be with their original movies. Like, high school is not possible whatsoever. You're going to have very dark stuff, you're going to have bullies, you're going to have lots of homework, you're not going to sing that whatsoever. It's always stupid. And also with the fact, also Disney Channel also have a lot of remakes or reboots whatsoever. They have like DuckTales reboot, I personally found to be a very good reboot. Could say that it's a very good reboot of the original show, or some people, yeah, I see like a comments in the Dutch version about it's not like the original. The art style looks too stupider. I like to always say reboots always have a different art style. And I personally was like, oh yeah, it's not, the chain is different. But when I saw the cartoon itself, it was pretty good and I like it. The characters in themselves, like, they have different personalities. Well, because from the original, they don't have that. Same with TMNT 2012. They didn't. They had different personalities in the older versions. Lesser. So that is good stuff. And the fact is that they do the concept of an action, sorry, like an adventure comedy, that they're going to still do the theme of the original. It's also a good sign, because if you look at Cartoon Network, it's a good example. You have Ben 10 reboot, you have the Power Buggles reboot. They focus more on comedy than action. As definitely Powerpuff Girls reboot, they're doing like more lifestyle. That's the type of stuff I personally don't. It's not that not make the original good, because it was the action scenes, the awesome villains. Yeah, just awesome time there was, because then it was like they saved the day. And do they do it now? No. You see the narrator on the end of the video, Powerpuff Girls have saved the day, and tomorrow they're going to do it again, or whenever the telephone is ringing for emergency, whatever. And this similar thing as at least Disney Channel does a good job of it. We also have other fucking things like they have Tangles, whatever, animated series about that. They have also have Big Hero 6 series. They have different type of movies and series. They also have going to have Monsters, Inc., whatever. Going to have also an animated series about that. I don't know if it's going to be like the original or it's going to be very cheaper looking. They'll probably do that. Don't think that they don't know to have a very big budget like in Nickelodeon. But they, you're going to want to see whatsoever their shows look like the movies. A bit cheaper, like visual cost lowered. But they look like the original movies and I can accept that again. You see a good thing about it. Not every cartoon-based movie, whatever, was good, but there were some good ones in between that. So yeah. But overall, like Disney overall needs to sit down with some other creators and think about some original concepts. Not going to drop some live action movies that just retell the story, but then in live action or animated CGI. You're saying can do some creative stuff. Do that again. Because I'm going to be really mad if it's going to like say, hey, let's go to make a live action movie about a Bambi or the Aristocrat Cats or other Disney Channel movies that they still have not live action made. But you need to do that because I know you have Marvel and Star Wars, but you also need to have something new, something creative, different, not the same. Try to innovate, try to make your magic again. It's not that you have to do something with princesses or princes or like something magical. You can also do something regular or different, but just go all out with concepts. Don't see that animated movies, whatever, that's going to be awesome for everybody, for every age, or kids, teenager, adult. You need to have your magic right there with you, because otherwise, when does it stop? Because at some point, you have made every single live action movie, animated movie in a live action movie. What do you have then? Oh yeah, then your creativity is going to stop because you have to work, whatever, because you have already made every single movie again. Oh yeah, let's go, maybe we're going to redo an animated movie that was like seen like lesser in animated quality, and we're going to improve that with maybe better like voice acting and just overall scenes, artwork, whatever that you can do. But personally, simply Disney need to improve and not rely on live action movies just based on original animated ones, because we love them. We love them because we watch them as we are young, or our parents watched them back then. We want to have old good memories still there, but you don't have to remake it. And not with the fucking girl from Harry Potter, by basically singing with auto-tune and doing absolutely nothing while standing in the open field. While in the animated one, she actually moves, touching the flowers and like that. Because you want to do exactly what you see of the anime movies to live action. Just see the movie yourself. Okay, so see a clip, you see a scene. Well, we're going to do exactly like the scene. And now it's going to say retell it and do it cheaply. I had to be that, man. We will see what Lion King, Adele of whatever, Will Smith thing. I don't know what to expect. I'm going to say bro, whatever. Could be fucking hilariously stupid. Personally, that's been incident to watching that, but we will see how Will Smith is going to be that. Really, guys, sorry. I know it's going to be a pretty long video about this problem. This thing I want to address. I want to really know, what do you think about Disney with the current lineup of live-action movies, you're still doing this type of stuff. We want to know, and hopefully the future will see brighter. But we will see. We'll see, guys. I hope you guys see you in the next video. We'll drop in with the song, of course. Disney-related, of course, this time. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase.
Hakuna Matata. Ain't no peasant craze.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
It's our problem-free philosophy.
Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata?
Yeah, it's our motto.
What's the motto?
Nothing. What's the motto with you? You know, kid, these two words will solve all your problems.
That's right. Take Pumbaa, for example. Why? When he was a young warthog.
When I was a young warthog.
Very nice.
Thanks.
He found his aroma like a certain appeal. He could clear the savannah after every meal.
I'm a sensitive soul, though I seem thick-skinned. And it hurt that my friends never stood downwind. And oh, the shame!
He was a shame.
What a change in my name!
Oh, what's your name?
And I got downhearted.
How did you feel?
Every time that I...
Hey, Pumbaa, not in front of the kids.
Oh, sorry. Hakuna Matata, what a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata, ain't no passing craze.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
Yeah, say it, kid.
It's our problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata.